Dave DeBoer.
Coming up on The Disturbance, we take a quick look at the Toronto Raptors' Game 4 victory over the Boston Celtics, thus tying up the series 2-2. I will tell you why the Toronto Raptors won, and I will tell you why the Boston Celtics lost. All of that, and as always, trust me, a whole lot more coming up on The Big Show. I am Dave DeBoer. This is The Disturbance. Please, if you're watching this on YouTube, go ahead and hit that big red subscribe button. If you're listening to us on any of the various 100-plus, podcast platforms that exist across the universe, go ahead and subscribe as well. If we do a deep dive into this game, and I don't do a lot of these deep dives into games. We'll do a lot more of that in the National Football League when the season kicks off next week. And especially in basketball. I mean, yeah, the season's so long, the playoff series are so long. But today, it was sort of a pivotal game. It was a chance for Toronto to tie things up at 2, which they did. And it was also a chance for Boston to pull back ahead up 3-1, which they didn't. Now, as I watched today's game, it was clear that Nick Nurse did a slightly better job coaching. Now, I say that a slightly better job coaching. Look, I think a lot of Brad Stevens as a head coach, and he made a lot of decent adjustments. He made the kind of adjustments that actually kept the Celtics in this game. Still, Nick Nurse, I don't know how many different defenses he ran. Look, I for years coached kids basketball. And I would run the box and one with my kids all the time. I actually saw Nick Nurse during the fourth quarter of an NBA playoff game go to a box and one. Like, I bet you some of the players on the Celtics were like, I haven't seen this in 10 years. So Nick Nurse did a good job sort of mixing things up with their defense. But beyond that, the modern day National Basketball Association, as we all know, is really about three-point shooting. If you shoot well from the three-point stripe, you will have a chance of winning. Now, there's a whole concept of actually having the ability, in other words, having the right players on your team to be able to actually commit to a three-point strategy, sort of like the Houston Rockets. If the Rockets are having a good night, they certainly can get their entire team to commit to a three-point strategy. If they're having an off night, you might as well go ahead and pencil in a victory for the other team. That's just how the Houston Rockets are set up. The Toronto Raptors are sort of set up in a similar way. And tonight, they went 17 for 44 from the three-point line. It was a good night for them, sort of across the board. And this was actually the big difference in the game. If you look at how the Boston Celtics did from the three-point line, they went 7 for 35. Let's get this straight. They had 10 less successful three-pointers in tonight's game, and they lost by 7. If there is one person that we can clearly address and point to the reason why the Celtics lost tonight's game, this particular person went 2 for 11. This particular person went to Cal. This particular person's name is Jaylen Brown. Jaylen Brown went 2 for 11. From the three-point line. Look, I watched the entire game tonight, and I can tell you that I don't know what was wrong with Jaylen. He looked like he was taking the night off. He looked like he was dreaming of what he was going to order from the local Denny's and have it delivered at midnight. Like, I don't know why Jaylen Brown was sleeping as much as he was on the court earlier today. So that was the big difference in the game. Three-point shooting. the fact that the Celtics had one of their best three-point shooters completely sort of fall off the wall and just shoot 2 for 11. You know, one other factor I want to mention before we get out of here is that the Nick Nurse coaching strategy was to play three guys a lot. Brad Stevens decided to do something sort of similar, but didn't quite do it at the same level that Nick Nurse did. Brad Stevens played Jason Tatum 43 minutes, so he was basically in the game most of the time. Kemba Walker had 41 minutes, which is a lot of minutes for Kemba. He's got a lot of miles on those tires. And Marcus Smart had 41 minutes as well, which is too many minutes for Marcus Smart. I can tell you that right now. So, but Nick Nurse on the other side decided to really play his players a lot. Siakam, 46 minutes in tonight's game. Siakam played 46 minutes. It worked. He scored 23 points. Kyle Lowry, 22 points, and he played 44 minutes. He was the one player that slacked of the three amigos. He only played 44 minutes. And Van Vliet, who had 17 points, played, and by the way, had some clutch threes in the fourth quarter, played 45 minutes into tonight's game. Look, the reality is the Celtics would have probably won tonight's game if Jaylen Brown had actually showed up. And congrats to Nick Nurse for recognizing that he wasn't going to show up and mixing things up enough on defense so that he could find a way to win a game. Look, if anything, this was really good coaching on both sides of the fence. Nick Nurse, though, did a slightly better job. And that's why this series is all tied at 2. All right. Thanks so much for tuning in to The Disturbance. Do check out our website at mighty.rip when you have a chance. If you haven't subscribed to the big show, please go ahead and do that. For The Disturbance, I am Dave DeFaw, reminding you that for more semi-witty sports commentary, make sure you check out our website at mighty.rip.
The Disturbance is a production of the Mighty Rip Podcast Network. Okay, go ahead and properly cast.